We have one, but she's from Scotland.
Oh.
So technically, it's not the same language. So.
Oh my God, that's hilarious!
You are signing in French for the one person who's hearing impaired who's from Scotland.
You can't write that, people. You can't write that.
I have a question for Jessica. Is Elisa a good kisser?
No. Yeah. Yes, of course. Beautiful. I mean, who here wouldn't want to kiss Eliza? She's gorgeous. She was a great kisser. And really, really wonderful. That was my first day on set, actually. And it was really uncomfortable. Because, of course, my brother is Murphy, Richard. And he wasn't there that day. But I had to show up and speak 6 pages of Grounder day one and have a sex scene with Clark. And
I'm going to start watching this show. Oh my God, this sounds great!
You've been missing out. And had to take my top off and it, so it was happening. So I basically showed up and was like, hi, I've heard so much about you. I'm Richard's sister. I take my top off now? Okay, great. But Eliza was...
What episode was this?
Plenty of goddamn business. Season 4. She was wonderful. She's a wonderful actress and a wonderful person to work with. She was great.
And a good kisser.
And a fucking great kisser. That was
awesome.
Can we do... No.
Yeah.
Oh no. Not again.
With this?
No, the whole cast.
The whole cast?
I would kill Thomas because he's already dead.
So, no hard feelings, right?
Honey, close your ears. Kiss Lexa. Just a little tiny innocent one, though. And I would marry... Maybe Eliza? Maybe Eliza. Oh. I married Lincoln.
And let's be honest, that dude's hot.
And he dies too, so I'm not committed to the relationship for long.
Yeah. cute, so I guess I'm gonna have to, I'll marry Thomas. Because I can also get out of a relationship with him, okay?
He's got that on camera too, so.
I would kiss, I'd marry this one over here, because he's adorable, and he's dead, so I like Ty's thinking. And then, I'd kill my brother, because, obviously. And then, kiss? Oh. Do I just have to choose one? There's really good people on the show. I'm gonna go with... Let's go with Harper. Because she's here. Because she's hot.
Can you, each of you, tell us a Wagner sentence in the dialect?
The business was the chaos, and don't come from here to Sintangongong.
No, those were some of my lines. Because they're never going to go away. I memorized them forever.
Sounded better in French, right? Sounded way better in French. I don't remember any grounder, but I'll give a free selfie picture to the person who can tell me what show this is from. Ich bin nicht in der Stadt in Konomen. A sci-fi show, and I don't know why I remember that line. I don't remember any grounder, but...
Tell the sentence again.
If I get it right. Ich bin nicht in der Stadt in Konomen. Yay! Free selfie after this.
Vous avez perdu là. À part la série The Angel, quelle est votre série préférée? Pourquoi?
Anyone that I am in. Because that means I'm employed. I don't watch a lot of TV, to be honest. The only show I have seen all the episodes of in probably 15 years, and I'm actually already a season behind, is Game of Thrones. I don't know what it is, but you know, because it always surprises people as an actor that I don't watch a lot of TV and I don't watch a lot of movies. But I always say, why would I watch another actor's representation of life when I can go out in the real world and see life? What I do as an artist is recreate life, real life. So it doesn't offer that much to me to go watch somebody else's interpretation of it. I'd rather go out and live in the real world and meet people and have experiences with people. And that's what I feed on as an actor. So
everything. I watch basically any like cold case, like Forensic Files type of thing. Dateline. I'm going to go with Dateline. Anything on Dateline. Dateline. Like real life, like cases, murder mystery, like Chris.
Okay, donc c'est vrai qu'elle regarde pas mal de séries quand elle est
vieille. To catch a predator.
Hi, so do you know how to speak French? And if yes, can you say something?
Bonjour.
Voulez-vous coucher avec moi? Maya? I don't speak a lot of French. I wish both my children were put into French immersion, so they speak fluent French, because I believe it's important to have multiple languages. I think it's good for your brain, it's good for development, and it's good for all of us worldwide to be able to communicate better. So my daughters speak fluent French, unfortunately.
Carry on.
Unfortunately, for some reason it didn't stick when I was younger. But you know what's funny is I find myself answering in French when somebody, like the other day, somebody hands me, like Maya, my girlfriend, who's Anglais, and oh, merci. And then somebody else, a waiter, I said it, I can't do it now, so I won't, but I said like something simple like merci, but I said it with my accent so good, he started speaking to me in French. I'm like, wait a minute. He's like, your accent was so good. I'm like, yeah, I'm an actor, I faked it. But no, I don't speak a lot of French, except for those key words. And, salle de bain?
Escargot, steak tartare, and beer? Beer. I don't know. Je ne sais pas. I'm just saying beer with an accent. Beer. Beer. I've got nothing. Dateline.
I don't speak French either, I'm afraid.
When you guys come up to me and apologize for your English, know this, your English is infinitely better than my French.
Tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night.
And above
all,
the
world,
these are the
nights.
That's probably it. Someone loyal, someone clean.
A nice smile, really nice eyes, and doesn't mind somebody that works long hours.
Right here.
Yeah. Jarper. Hashtag Jarper.
I think your dating website would say, Abby!
Because I'd be asking her for help. Abby, can you write my dating website for me? Jackson. Abby?
Bah, son plus gros fou rire sur le plateau, c'est à un moment une scène, alors elle veut pas spoiler, mais c'est une scène où en gros il y a énormément de monde sur le plateau, c'est une scène genre bien dramatique, où ils doivent ils sont pas bien, ils sont tous complètement déprimés, ils font tous la tête, ils sont tous machin, et à se, comment on dit là, quand, à se recueillir, voilà, ils sont tous en train de se recueillir, il y a énormément de figurants derrière eux. Et donc pendant ce grand silence, et en fait il y a un des figurants derrière qui en a lâché une bonne, enfin qui a lâché une caisse. Et en gros, pendant le grand silence de recueillement, on entend
et donc, much là, better fart than I did.
Et donc là ils sont tous en mode, non vas-y on rigole pas, Et on coupe, on leur dit, ils essayent de se reconcentrer. C'est bon, c'est reparti, et le mec, bim, une deuxième. Et en fait, quatre fois, et là ça a été terminé, en fait, tout le monde mort de rire, enfin, voilà. Mais on peut pas me dire quelle c'est, parce qu'il n'est pas encore sorti.
What does your fart sound like?
Dernier appel pour Bob et Jared, s'il vous plaît. This is the last call for Bob and Jared.
Two types of farts.
Two types of farts.
One.
That sounds like the start to a beatbox.
It is. It's very musical. And two.
The squeaker.
The squeaker. It's the most dangerous one.
Donc, ils sont partis sur les paix. Il dit, donc dans les paix, il y en a deux. Il y a le... Il y a celui-là. Et après, il y a le... Il y a celui auquel on s'attend pas, vous savez, le petit... Il dit, ceux-là, c'est les plus dangereux. C'est vraiment les ceux où...
I only did it to hear him do it.
Ils disent que c'est ça que je voulais être très bon. Ils disent que je l'ai juste fait parce que je voulais pouvoir le faire.
And while in LA, I went for dinner with Joel Joseph, who plays Miller. And this is my first convention, and he shared with me that he's been on a few, and he said, Chelsea, it's really fun, obviously, to travel, and obviously to get paid to travel. But he said, Chelsea, the most touching part is meeting the fans. Yeah, he said, I know it almost makes me tear up. He just said it's so nice to, I'm jet lagged, it makes me cry. He just said it's really easy, the most memorable part. Is meeting you guys and seeing how much that he has the power to affect other people. So did I ever...
I love you! I love you!
We love you! Did I ever expect anyone to recognize me without the wig and the blood? No. So to have that, to see that you even recognize me when I feel like I look like a totally different person, to see you bare your hearts and you guys travel so far to come see us, or not sleep, or take the train, or fly out, we're so touched. We never expect it, and we love you. I'm sorry, you're making me cry, Chelsea. No, it's good tears, right?
Yeah. Happy tears.
Yes.
Non-100 tears.
Well, let's get serious, and I'm sorry for asking this after this sentimental moment, but Scream Queen, I told you I would ask you this. You have to recreate your scream from the second season. Okay. And Sachin can play the drill.
Oh, it's the part I was born to play.
This is role play, huh?
Take that for what you will.
He said it's the part he was born to play. Okay, I gotta hydrate.
You gotta stand up, right?
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Okay,
I feel like I should scream.
Don't do it into the mic.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's fine. You don't need it. You're standing. Okay. As soon as I hit your back, ready? He's got to translate.
With action. Get up here, we'll drill while you translate.
we'll both drill. Okay? Yeah. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Let's get a job.
Well, I'm pretty sure he's got a turn now, right? Let's watch his turn. As
you have to get
through your bone marrow. I'm Dr. Singh and I'm coming in.
I think that, you know, there's a lot of things that he regrets, but also you have to keep in mind that Pike was voted in by a landslide. So, I mean, Bellamy obviously didn't want Kane, Sinclair, or Lincoln, all the sick rounders to die, which is why he went out and tried to, recruit Octavia. I think there's probably some sort of resentment as well to, and this is only my opinion, but I'm letting make that clear. But there is probably some resentment towards Brian, Monty, Miller, and everyone else who was there that let Lincoln do that. Even Kane stood there and let Lincoln sacrifice himself. So, you know, I think that the questions need to be asked of them too, but I don't think they necessarily do get asked.
Henry was absolutely brilliant in the scene. Freezing cold, rain, shooting this, hung on this X for 10 hours. And I had never, 30 years in this business, I have never seen someone so professional and so calm under those circumstances. I don't know how I could have done it, but that's why that's one of my favorite scenes, because these guys have been, since season one, been working in the elements much longer than Henry, Ian Cusick, and I have. But to watch that man perform the way he performed in those elements, yeah, it was very special to me.
Marie, où elle lui, pareil, elle le castagne, et il dit c'est vraiment hyper important et bon. Il dit là, contre saison 13, épisode 3, saison 3, épisode 13, où il est avec Eliza, il est avec Eliza sur la plage, on the beach, with Eliza.
It's not ménage à trois.
Donc il est avec Eliza sur la plage et il dit ça fait du bien aussi d'avoir une scène qui est un peu plus ralentie, qui est un peu plus posée et où on peut juste entrer dans, dans l'émotionnel.
Yeah, that's it. Just a question, what episode are you guys up to here in Paris?
Actually, we're not in it. It's just we all watching in on internet.
Okay.
Just to be fair, c'est vrai.
Illegally.
Illégalement.
No, we are the number one rated show in the world illegally. Number one.
Oh, the evolution of Bellamy. You know, I know that a lot of people mean so. Yeah, I know that a lot of people aren't, like the fans of Bellamy aren't very happy with the, you know, the evolution or the character development. Character development doesn't necessarily have to go in a positive way. It can always can go backwards and can be negative. That's just life. For me, it's always a challenge to play him, and you know, it's that's the thrill of it for me. I don't take it personally when the fans dislike my character. It just usually means that I'm doing my job well. So whichever way it goes, good or bad, I'm just happy to try and find the truth and play the truth in the scene. Yeah.
Qu'un personnage il évolue de la bonne manière. Il dit moi je suis aussi très content. Je fais bien. Il dit donc en gros mon défi est mon.
Who would it be?
Vous pouvez être un autre personnage dans la
série.
If you had a chance to be another character in the show, which one would it be?
Wow. Wow. I don't know. I love. That was going to get controversial. I was going to say that, but that would be really controversial. I really like all of the women on the show. They're so strong. I have to say, man, Indra, Anya, obviously, Commander Lexa, Octavia, all those characters.
I'd love for you to be my little sister.
I just think that the journey of our women are extremely complex. I can't say I've seen every TV show or every film, but I am extremely proud of the strength of all of our characters that are women in our show. So, you know, all of them.
Isaiah is basically saying he wants to be a woman.
Yeah, it was pretty controversial, yeah. That's why, yeah, thank you, Bob, thank you. But I do think that I would like to play Jaha, but I would like to see him getting closer to the Grounders as well. Or maybe create his own clan, like Sancha crew.
But you had that season one and you killed everyone. That's what you did with your own clan.
Hush, boy, hush. I'm working something here. Hush. Sancha crew. I'm going to say it again. Sancha crew. The Light People, season four.
Playing another character,
I first want to say that those characters that are on the show wouldn't be what they are without the actors behind them, and they do great work. So I just want to precursor this answer by saying there's no way in the world I'd be able to play any character better than these guys do their job. I think my castmates are freaking awesome, and I enjoy working with every one of them. I have said before that I'd like to play Ali.
I'm listening.
Ali, yeah, you know, the high heels in the red dress. Yeah, her.
A hologram.
Yeah, man, but she's flawless. I mean, there's obviously some flaws. I'm killing him.
I'm listening.
Anyway, no, I mean...
I think I got you.
I really love what Devin is doing with Jasper this season. He's so involved with his work and he takes it very seriously. And I think the depths that he's taken Jasper excite me. So, you know, the chance to do that with the character is really thrilling. So I'm drawn to that. I also love Raven. She's brilliant. Lindsay is doing an amazing, amazing job. And the last couple of episodes that came out, like Triggers and the one before that,
Nevermore,
were so brutal to shoot. And she's such a trooper. It was pretty amazing to watch. I love every character on this show, but, you know, and my answer to that question changes every time you ask me. But I'm very much happy playing Bellamy at the moment.
Did you taste something that is really French to go? We're not talking about wine.
No, right? No, great. I just had some great Bordeaux. But escargot, yes, I've had it just last night here. I've had it abroad, but...
In Dresden.
I wanted to have it here. It still tastes the same, really salty. You need a lot of garlic, but it's good, yes. The French food is good.
I had... It's like a bean dish. With cassoulet. Yeah, that thing, yeah. Yeah, it was cassoulet. Yeah. That's heavy. that was quite heavy, but I mean, today I woke up, I went out on my balcony, I looked at your pigeons, and they're so robust, they're like quite hefty, like a hefty pigeon. And I was like, it must be the bread here, because it's bloody delicious.
Du coup, je vous demande de faire un tonnerre de applaudissements pour moi.